Justin, Justin! We didn't make a cold open last week. Now we only have, 35 seconds to make one.
We could use the time machine. It's right over there.
Let's do it.
Okay. All right, punch it. This doesn't look like last Tuesday. Guess it didn't work.
All right! Smooth as can be! Just like we'd always planned it, Justin Robert Young, as we have always done and always shall be. We're starting off with our regular Thursday night edition of Night Attack, bringing you the best of the worst of the internet ever since we thought of that idea at the beginning of time.
Yeah.
Hey, beautiful people, live from Austin, Texas, I'm Justin Brian, and live in Austin is Brian Justin.
Hi, I'm Brian Justin.
Hey,
oh,
man.
I'm sorry, wait, did you not pick up on that? That's my Ryan Connolly impression.
Oh, goddammit. All right, you want to just start with that and break it? First of all, we got to recap what the hell happened, because we started with an apology last episode. Anyone who downloaded.
I also didn't even see the apology. What was the apology?
I don't remember. I just remember.
All I know, like,
literally,
this conversation is happening with somebody in Atlanta or in the Atlanta suburbs and Austin.
Right.
While I am in California.
Right.
And it is a back and forth, like, text a second conversation.
Right.
That is happening at 6 in the morning.
While you're trying to sleep.
And is at like 5:45 to 6 in the morning.
Yeah. It's like we're talking about the nuances of how we're going to handle it. And the answer is like, shut the fuck up, kids.
Well, I just don't even know.
Did that even true, man? I didn't even know what was that.
So, like, I all of a sudden just like, bing, 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 bing. I look over at my phone when I finally wake up. And I see that Cheeto and Brian have been having this conversation about how to salvage the episode, what exactly we have, what we don't have. The decision is basically settled by the time that I actually wake up,
yep,
that we're just going to release it as is. And as we had decided at the end of last week's episode, I'm coming down to Austin. I mean, I said, fuck it. We make it up to the fans no matter what. On my own dime, I'm flying down to Austin immediately so we can do an in-person episode.
Man, I'd really like that to be exactly how it happened. That's that would be amazing. All right, for the first time, we'll see my apology. I don't even know.
Howdy, guys. Brian Brushwood recording the morning after Night Attack. And boy, howdy, did we have a lot of technical kerfluffles. It was a confluence of horrible events. The stream kept going down, and some of the recordings that were backed up on MetaCDN got corrupted. However, our crack team was able to put together the entire show you're about to listen to. There are 4 breaks where you'll just hear a little bit of, like, bleep. Just pretend like the show had a stroke during those times, and we'll keep on going.
That's great.
Moving forward. We're going to make it up to you. We're going to do a bonus show this week on Thursday.
That's what we're
Justin
doing right
will
now.
Be live in studio, oh, yeah. Hey. And hopefully everything will run a lot smoother. You'll hear us talking about possibly doing trial by jury that didn't end up.
All right, whatever, shut up. So anyway, that was the promise, and it's not an empty promise because here we are and things seem to be actually working. I guess it turns out that the culprit was trying to send stuff to Daily Motion. Daily Motion had been slowly shitting the bed.
Riding so, backwards on a dick, Daily Motion.
So, okay, so you teased at the outset the Ryan Connolly.
No, I was just, oh, here, you want to hear my Ryan Connolly impression?
Yeah, here, let me
All right,
hear.
Here we go. This let is my
hear.
Ryan Connolly impression.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm Ryan Connolly. I do Film Riot. Was that good?
All right, first of all, I had to
Was that
to
a
memorize...
good Ryan Connolly impression?
It's certainly heartfelt.
Hey, Josh, you better stop monkeying around. That's my Ryan Connolly impression.
I want
I'm
you
known
to know...
for my impressions, Brian. Everybody knows I do impressions.
I want you to know that I actually did take a moment to study his mannerisms.
Oh, did you?
And then, and
did
to
you
match.
Get into method? Were you
I tried
like,
to. This like, is the funny thing is I'm actually trying in this case. So it's like I'm all proud of the fact that.
So
I,
let's set the scene.
Okay,
Brian, you have a show called Scam Scream.
Wow, we're going way back.
Way back. We're going the all
the
way back.
Internet was invented in 1960s.
Exactly. So. With Scam School, you like this show, have become known for interesting advertising. Fun,
sure.
Watchable, interesting advertising. It's something that Brandt, part of Team Brushwood out here in Austin,
yep.
has very much taken as his pet project.
That yep.
Sometimes these are fucking gorgeous, like short films that he just totally murders. Like, I mean, he's done parodies of like Her.
It's so good that we have a playlist now. If you type in Scam School ads, somebody was like, can I see a playlist just of all the Scam School ads? And sure enough, that thing exists on the fantastic BB Live videos. Is that what it is? Yeah, BB.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. And it should, because they're rad. So you, another person on the Discovery networks,
right,
is Ryan Connolly, of course, our friend at Film Riot.
Right.
He also does funny ads. They very much have their own style to them. His whole show, all the stuff that he does has a very distinct comedic and visual style. So you and Brant put together
a
parody of the Film Riot ad.
All right, and here's the thing. Is structurally, I hear what you're saying, because his opening is very similar, because I say, welcome to Scam School, the only show dedicated to social engineering at the bar and on the street. Hello, I'm your host, Brian Brushwood.
Yeah.
He says something totally different. Yeah. He says, welcome to Film Riot, with the show that takes the mystery out of the effects and tricks used by some of your favorite Hollywood productions or movies. So
it's an introduction.
I had to memorize that. Whatever. This is me. This is me. And also, the character is supposed to be Brian doing a bad impression
because of a puppy.
It's supposed to be me doing an impression.
All right, everybody, calm down. We want to hear the impression.
Hello, I forgot one thing. It's me, Ryan Connolly, the host of Film Riot, the show that takes the mystery out of the effects and techniques to go into some of your favorite Hollywood films. And I have an important update.
All right, now you give me that line as Brian.
All right. Hello, beautiful people. It's Brian Brushwood. Welcome you to Scam School, the only show dedicated to social engineering at the bar and on the street.
All right, now play it again.
Yeah, again. Well, you see, what I do, because I'm pretending to be Ryan Connolly, is I just have to put on like I'm affecting like a fake voice, like, hello, it's me, Ryan Connolly. But I'm still going to talk really fast because Ryan speaks really fast. That's the other thing, is he speaks extremely quickly during his tutorials.
Right, the show that takes the mystery out of the effects and techniques to go into some of your favorite Hollywood films, and I have an important update.
See, also, he does this, like, bobbing forward thing and gesturing constantly with his hands where he's almost about to steeple in a Mr. Burns pose, but never quite does.
Totally different from you, who stays exactly still.
Well,
and has both arms as if there were 50-pound weights in them at all times, perfectly harnessing your frame, right?
All right, so we're, like,
because we got an important letter from a handsome gentleman who says, Dear Film Riot, isn't there a cooler promo code to use than Film Riot when registering domains?
Okay, no, listen. I'm breaking balls here. And the more we go, like, this is a brilliant parody. Like visually, and like, it looks great. It's very, very funny. I'm just breaking your balls.
No, that's fine. That's fine. Deservedly so.
I don't think it's a failure of execution. I just think it's like, if
it, like, the problem is it's like, it's
like I couldn't do a very good impression of you because our speaking styles, although we know that they're different,
right,
they probably don't sound all that different to other people.
Right.
And that's the difference.
Yes.
Is that like, you know that you sound different than
Ryan. We have the one
Ryan.
Guy with the scratchy voice and the other guy with the scratchier voice.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's not a failure of execution. It's like, it might be an impossible thing to do.
Okay, but
without having a touchstone, right? It's like, it's like the same thing with like SNL impressions or something, where like Dana Carvey, it all comes back to like, wouldn't be prudent.
Oh, that's just, like, yeah, well, just, and that's need, all the best the impressions. Yeah. Correct. All the best impressions identify something, like whenever anybody does an impression, they're doing an impression of someone else's impression, right? We can all do it. Nobody could do a George Bush impression.
Yeah.
Dana Carvey, flipped the switch. All of a sudden, everybody knew how to do
all
a
great
Dana
impressions.
Yeah.
Repeat the names twice in every sentence.
And reference
large,
poorly rolled blunts,
yeah,
and
exactly.
Hot tubs. But this is
my name is Ryan Connolly. I teach you After Effects. I drink poorly warmed milk, and I live happily in a Dallas suburb.
I'm Ryan Connolly.
I'm Ryan Connolly.
Please watch Film Riot. I'm very sober right now.
Well, sir, that's
I work with all of my family because our relationship is very healthy.
Domain.com. Now, at this point, you don't need After Effects, but it doesn't hurt to put some motion blur and a little bit of turbulent displacement on there. Turbulent displacement when I'm curving on your face. Then you're going to to type in a top-level domain of your choice. Is that Brand? But when you
that's an actual clip from Josh because that's one of the things he does, these non sequiturs that go to all these weird places. But we're coming to the moment where it was a last-minute addition where just this phrase popped into my mind, like, oh, we should do like they do and cut to, you know, this random trapping weird thing.
Okay, I'll make sure to use promo code SCAMSCHOOL. This is me, Ryan Connolly.
Which, by the way, I felt really a little bit bad. The whole conceit of this is that Brian sneaks onto the set of Film Riot and then tells Ryan's
Film
audience
Riot
to
fans.
Not support Film Riot, but instead support my show.
Oh, that could have been meaner, though. You could have done that meaner.
Oh, yeah. No. Well, yeah. I mean, I dialed it back specifically because
like, yeah.
I didn't want
I've been convicted for dealing drugs. And now I need all of your support to go to scam school. I am unworthy of your affection. I'm Ryan Connolly.
All right. I am a fraud and a scam artist, which is why you should support Scam School. So here's the...
I have fallen from grace. As the night star, the angel fell from heaven, thus becoming Lucifer. Do not support me.
Reminding you to use promo code SCAM SCHOOL or else you'll be some kind of reckless hobo.
Look out, photos, reckless hobo.
Mm-hmm.
He is out here trekking solo.
True.
Reckless hobo.
That's it for the bonus tutorial.
All right, so this is the golden moment. I don't care about anything else this entire episode. This moment of realizing that this is all Brandt rapping. Given us the full, like, Flint Flossy True in there. And then meanwhile, also the visual for the audio listeners is just me jauntily, and this is also skating the razor's edge because I don't want to make fun of the homeless, but you know, we're
making fun of the homeless.
Well, but okay, well, I'm definitely sporting, I'm definitely.
And besides, what are they gonna do? Go to the library and write you an email?
Did I ever tell you that they like warned us? We did a when I was in GT program in high school, we did a trip to the downtown Houston library, and they had to warn us that a lot of homeless people use the library. Little bit of checking the Playboy archives right in front of the high school students.
Oh yeah, and that was pre-internet or widely distributed internet, right?
Yeah.
No, now like they're. A friend of mine who now actually covers like money and politics, one of the a big expose that he did working at the Dallas Morning News was the epidemic, and it is an epidemic of people, homeless people or otherwise,
masturbating
in the library.
Well, that's the thing I guess during that phase, now I guess being a teenager, because I remember taking a trip to the library with my girlfriend at the time, and hey. If we're going to mess around, we should research how sex works. And we went to like the sex section of the library. And then it's like, you're like, oh shit, I'm reading about sex. This is so hot. And then it's like, well, we're at a library though. So now what? I guess we'll drive the half hour ride home.
Time out.
All right.
Time out.
This is such goddamn.
You know where I'm going to go. All right. Right?
This is a total Brian
way to
handle this.
You know where I'm going to go.
Where?
Don't think that you can ice skate by that you went to a library,
public library,
research
downtown.
Sex.
Yeah, no, we wanted to know
before you fucked for the first time.
Oh yeah.
So this is
like
just
we were fucking around, you know, but yeah, no, it wasn't until like college that I went all the way.
We're giving away a Night Attack track tonight. We fucked up so bad in the last episode that we are giving away would be a centerpiece for an album track. So
well,
hold
I'll
on.
Tell you what, we better fucking hurry before Bonnie gets home because this shit
let's
ends.
Let's go. Let's go. So you are screwing. How old are you?
What? 17 at the time.
So 17.
Yeah.
What grade is that in high school for you?
Yeah, I think it was the summer before senior year.
Okay, so you got a lot of time in your hands.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Summertime.
Yeah.
With his hats. Who brings up? We need to research.
Who do you
sex.
Think fucking brings it up? I mean, it's like
I don't know this lady.
Okay, geez, now we're on super icy territory.
I don't know if you're. I don't know if you're dating Kathy from the comic strip Kathy.
Hold on, keep talking.
Is it this one?
Oh, it's off.
We haven't gotten. No, we haven't done this,
no,
right?
No.
This has been my thing, though.
What do you mean?
That if some people want to take fucking license, other people can take license too.
I mean, all
this is a two-way street.
I'm gonna say is this shit is definitely in a book. You can definitely read You can read pieces of this story.
Well, although it's kind of screwed up because, like, she doesn't name you in this book.
Yeah, well, I ain't going to name her. But then if you find the book, you could probably piece it all together.
All right. So anyway, anybody who wants to research all the ex-girlfriends of Brian that have written memoirs about Brian. No, you're right. We've really thrown her into the bramble of anonymity. So it's all right. So it's this bitch.
All right. She's perfectly delightful.
No, and indefinite.
Okay.
Not,
but okay. So
not proper. Lowercase. Lowercase.
It's always a dildo. Never
your dildo. So you are the one who's like, we need to research how this fucking goes.
It may have been both of us because, like, you know what it was? Was it's like, you know, you fucking and again, I cannot convey enough how fucked up the world before the internet was.
Yeah.
Like you just had no, even if you knew a thing existed because of, like, you know, gossipy chatter, or because, like, you know, I knew fucked up shit existed because I was dialing into BBS bulletin boards and downloading, you know, not even animated GIFs, just GIFs,
yeah,
of nudie, of sex or whatever. And it's like, you don't know, like, is this representative? Is this a fringe thing or whatever? And so, you know, you find yourself like, hey, I totally bought this Cosmopolitan magazine because it has a fact about sex. A single fact about what's normal to do about sex.
And that's
sex.
What they had on the front cover. Yeah. It was like, yes, one fact about sex.
Yes, exactly. Although nowadays that would be...
But only one, it said in bold.
It's the inverse of today's clickbait. Like, you will believe this one fact about sex.
Well, they thought they had the racket going at Cosmo back in the day. It's
we've
got 52 facts. We're good for the year.
Yes. Well, not even that. It was like once a month, right? So the I guess it was weekly. So we're like, well, man, we should know. And so we go, and it's like,
well, hold on,
book.
Wait a minute. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
You're suggesting that you research to grease the wheels a little bit, right?
No. Because
if you really wanted to know, you could have just went by yourself. Instead, it's a group trip.
Oh well. I guess we both, I mean, I don't know. I think we both were really curious and pragmatic about it.
So you're both sitting there diddling each other when, with your free hand,
it goes
into the air pointing, saying, Eureka, we should understand more of this.
No, not so much. At any rate, but.
I'm sorry. I really thought I was close there with my.
I mean, it's like, I don't know. It's different, man, because it's like. I mean, Bonnie and I have been married 17 years, and it's like you sort of like wall off. You're like, I guess there was a life before then that evolved.
Oh, no,
people,
yeah. Because when did you guys get married, you and Bonnie?
Dude, right out of college. Like, I proposed to her literally within a month of graduation. We got married within a year. So I've been married since 23, so 17 years now.
Holy hopscotch.
Yeah, right? In fact, I've spent at the time I was that age I was.
Yeah.
That's, I have spent that many years only with Bonnie.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, I have a hard time remembering shit like that I did. And like I have not been with anybody near as long, obviously, or had as many significant milestones beyond like marriage, kid one, kid two, kid three, houses, careers. Like, there's just like a lot of shit that you push. Like, oh, that time I got a blowjob in a car. Like, I don't know, delete, fucking whatever. Like, I got a lot of shit I got to store in this brain of mine. Like, fucking, that just goes away. I'm already fucking getting rid of my shit, and it's like there's nowhere near the amount of like stuff. So I can understand where shit gets fuzzy.
Well, and it's doubly bad because, like, the longer we've been together, the less courteous it would be to share the adventures of pre-Bonnie days.
I don't want to get into the fucking stuff, right? Like, really, all I want to get into is the curiosity in your brain alone.
Sure.
Like beyond, like fuck whatever the situation is between you and this other person, right? Like, I just want to know inside your own head.
Yeah.
What do you think you will gain knowledge-wise from going to the library
study? Yeah, no, this is great.
About sex.
It's actually a roadmap for normalization, for because we don't know, like, you know, what the average age is when people actually start doing it, or you know, how far they go, or, you know.
Y'all got friends that are fucking at this point?
Well, but again, that's a poor sample size. This is pre-internet world where it's like, these are the same people that tell you, you know, that it's normal to fuck a goat, you know, because they saw a kid do it once, or, you know, your friends don't know nothing. nothing.
What
especially
fucking high school did you go to?
Fuck you. You know. You know.
Fuck you. You know I'm a graduate of Goat Fuckers University.
I'm saying
GFHS football rules.
I'm saying that your friends are the type, because also it's like, you know, you got that backbiting thing. So it's like whatever you were doing with your girl, depending on your social circle, it's like you didn't share that, because then it's like people get around gossiping and your parents find out or whatever. Yeah. So it's like you're like, hey man, we're you know touching each other. And
how big was your high school? Is it a big high school?
It was 4A, 5A. It was a super 5A. It was like my graduating class was almost 1,000 or something like that.
Okay, so you were in a big high school.
Yeah,
you can tell your friends that size of high school.
No, because
does word just travel faster in Texas? Like, does the air is just lighter
it's
for
all
secrets?
All they fucking have, and it's like, and plus you would see people get destroyed, where it's like they would find out, and you saw people get destroyed by shit that wasn't even true, but it didn't matter.
Yeah,
it's like you fucking lived on the knife's edge of like fucking, you know, there's a girl that everybody knew had gonorrhea of the throat because. because she went down on a dude, or it's like that fucking shit, like,
yeah,
you know, and it's like
everybody knew that it was totally rad to fuck a goat,
you know, and plus it's like, you know, you're just excited that you're like you're getting your wiener touched. You don't want anyone knowing what, you know, what size it is, or just, you know, just details. You just don't want that shit out there,
I didn't anyway.
Yeah, and also it's like it's hard. In any situation, if you are like in a relationship in high school and then things go wrong and there's like hormones and hurt feelings and like,
well, yeah, and
now
also,
other
like,
people, like, now there's a reason to hurt somebody, like, I mean, that's rough. That's rough trade.
Keep in mind, also, I'm coming off of like 2 years of heavy involvement in my church youth group, and all of a sudden I'm not coming very often. Because I'm busy coming very often, you know? And it's like, you just don't want that shit to get around.
Exactly.
But, so at any rate, it was just this very pragmatic, like, I wanted to know what was normal, and I suppose she did too. I don't know, maybe she was playing me. But then we're like,
what long con is she running by researching sex in the library?
By like, oh, it's what he wants. So I'll be like, oh yeah, I totally want to know too. But I think she was genuinely.
No, that's actually a pretty brilliant, especially in a pre-internet era. No matter what you want to do.
Because it felt like a fucking adventure. We were going to go discover the secrets that we weren't supposed to know.
No girl's going to say, no, I don't want to understand the human body. Right,
right. Right.
Like, it's like, it is. Like, you could say, like, it would be like a cheesy high school video, like, we need to understand the human body, right? Like, we're both scholars.
Yeah.
Like, and that would be horseshit because you just want to grab titties.
Yeah.
Like, but you're like, I want to understand the human body, which is why we need to deliver these texts to our brains.
Yes.
Like, truly, let's don the robes and go out to the garden so we might better our minds.
Well, and also, it's like, literally, and again, I can't convey this enough. Before the internet, it was freaking insane. Like, we didn't know if there were better techniques for touching than we knew, you know? Because we're figuring this crap out, you know? Yeah.
Anyway. It's odd if you would find that in, like, library textbooks.
Oh, we definitely did. Yeah. No. It's like,
how are you touching before?
Well, no.
Please use your hands. Well, you're like, well, fuck, put your feet down.
No. It's like, well, here's what some people do. You can have sex. It's like, I found out about leg fucking at the library. I didn't know if that
really?
Was a thing. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Damn, what like books are at the Houston Library?
Dude, all of
it's
them.
Like leg fucking? Hmm. Hey, honey, do your tits hang low? Do they wobble to and fro?
Oh, dude, can you tie them in a bow? No, but it's like they had percentages of like what, you know, what women, you know, masturbate during the day while they're doing laundry and all this stuff. Just
really?
Yeah, dude. It's
what book
oh,
is
it's
this?
At the library. A world of facts and adventures.
Hi, everybody. My name is Justin Robert Young, and this is Brian Brushwood, and we're coming to you for the library.
And when we say coming to you, all right. Do you want to take a moment to? Well, here, wait. Can we just appreciate real quick the fact that I jauntily went up and down the street? You can see it's our neighborhood. And it's like we didn't want everybody to. I just realized it's spelled reckless. WRECKLESS. Like he's never been in a wreck.
No. Yeah.
He's a very safe driver. This hobo.
He's great, man. 10-2.
Mm-hmm. He is out here trekking solo.
So you can see those are the, first of all, that is a Diamond Club t-shirt tied onto a shower curtain rod. I'm wearing Bonnie's shirt and Bonnie's fashionable trench coat that happens to have these frayed edges. I'm holding a paper bag with a Listerine bottle inside, and you can see flying everywhere out of it are the kids'
Ryan Connolly, reminding you to...
Solo.
Those
true.
Are the kids'
that's it for the bonus tutorial.
Anyway, that's, it was a masterwork by one.
No, it looks very, very good. Brant is the best. He's really, really good. He's Add him on battle.net. He loves playing Hearthstone.
he's equally as the best as Bryce. They're
oh,
both
shit.
Fantastic.
Is this a thing?
No, I don't know.
Are you going to pit them against each other one day?
We're like, only one! You will consume the other's knowledge?
I have been training you up for this day.
Then double your money!
We're doing this fucking white label for everybody, right? This is just for everybody. We ain't got no ad reads, like, you know.
Yeah,
well, I guess we can mention the Patreon
because we're actually charging for this one. It's going to be a complete thing.
Yeah,
the
I mean, it was like it was an issue of kind of semantics on which one we charge for.
But regardless, we felt like you guys are paying us to do pro jobs, and so we're going to deliver pro jobs. In which case, we talk about. Blowjobs.
Where are you at on the regret scale right now that this came up?
You know, it all depends on. I mean, it's there's only one opinion that matters. That's my James Thurgood. Like this, and then you turn and you go to you know, let me drop some V's on you.
Hey, bro. You know, it's in a lot of people maybe out here in high school. Yes. Next thing you know, Johnny Football comes up to you and says, hey, Delilah, what do you say we go to the library? Learn about the devil's books. Maybe you're going to find out about leg fornicating.
Let me tell you, it may feel real good at the moment. And I mean, like, real good. Like, you may feel real good at the moment.
Sometimes... You might imagine yourself engorged with a supple leg wrapped around back and forth. And in that moment, you're going to know that there is one man frowning.
Oh, no. See, yeah. I thought you were going to go like if the version you should be telling for me is like, but listen, bro, one day. You're going to be married to another, more beautiful, delightful woman.
I know. And she's not going to take kindly
to the fact that you're a
making
leg
a bit about it on the internet. You know where that's going in the holy bounds of matrimony? That leg's going in the closet. And it ain't coming out for 2 years. You know who's going to get leg fucked?
Satan's supple leg.
God. It's the only person that gets leg fucked in this house.
Wow.
House of God. The church.
So
leg fucking Jesus. Hey, that's certainly not going to offend anybody.
And we're done. Patreon.com/nightattack. It was a good run while we had it. We certainly appreciate it. We're coming up on a year now.
Can you believe that?
Is it a year?
I think we were like, what, 2 weeks in when we did South By last year?
How terrified. Wait, we might, yeah. I guess it was right on at the beginning of March. This is
T-T-T-T-T. No, because we were planning South By.
Remember we wound down. We gave like 4 weeks notice at the beginning of February.
Yeah,
and then we started winding down. I thought that all went really well until it didn't.
Oh, you know.
Well, what can one do except exactly. for thank the fine 1,797 patrons who have pledged?
I think we found. Listen, we found everybody that matters.
You know what?
And that's all that it matters. I guess.
Think about all the elements that came together. Like even that.
This
that
is 51 and a half. Next week will be our 1 year of independence.
Man,
1 year
amazing.
Freed.
And of course, you know, thank
50
you to
weeks free.
50 shades of GTFO.
Dude, this coming here is always so fun. You know, it's always so much easier to do these shows live.
Well, it's like you get an unfair... Number one, we can actually interrupt each other if there's a better
there's
bit.
That.
Number two, it's astonishing what happens because, you know, there's... It's a little bit better because we rely on the two shots so much that we could kind of tell when the other one is queuing
doing
up for a thing.
Yeah.
But, you know...
By the way, you know, like, Carboni and Cannata, like, think that we're space aliens.
What do you mean?
That we can do the show that we do
not being
over
in
Skype.
The same room.
Yeah. Like that like they either of them understand how it's possible.
Yeah.
Like apparently we've gotten good at it.
Well, I think there is a rhythm that's a little bit different that you can't have. Like when we're in person, there's the little electricity that we want to keep the conversation to a certain level, like 100% at all times. But on Skype, we've just acknowledged that it needs to be 90%. Let's hit 90% and have those little gaps
well, it's
and
just
pauses
like right
and handoffs.
Now, all right, so it's like here's a good example. When we're on Skype, it's weird if I come back and say, like, oh, man, I like doing the show. That's like a lull in energy or it's like, okay, I'm not giving you anything, so you can't really kick it back. Like,
yeah.
It's like there needs to always be a thing going back and forth. When we're in the studio, we can understand, like, okay, well, you can see.
You know what
like,
it is?
You can feel the rhythm. You can hear the inflection of my voice better. Like, it's just a lot different.
There is no such thing as a comfortable silence whenever we're doing Skype. Here in studio, like, just then, you could tell that both of us were sort of wistfully, you know, looking back down memory lane for a moment and smiling. But over Skype, it'd be like, fuck, where's the funny?
I know.
It's not being funny.
We were drunkenly complimenting everybody in their family.
Butts! nice pooper!
Did we talk? We didn't talk so much about the Tay Allen 50 Shades of Tay video, right?
Well, I'll tell you what, man.
Because it was so fucked up with the Meta CDN thing and like, you know. I think it's safe to say that Tay is maybe one of the most unique people I've ever met in my entire life.
She is utterly fascinating in that, and I'm so thrilled that she has positively identified her unique character trait. You know, her special ability on the character sheet of what she has to offer is an unflinching ability to dive face first into the most awkward shit and then look you right in the eye. And be like, that's right.
Yeah.
That just happened.
It's fucking a real thing.
Yeah.
And now you have to deal with it. And the one thing I understood last week more than anything else is like, you know, all art comes from truth. And that lady wrote Mass Text and it came from the fact that she is really fucking paranoid about being left out of plans. Like, that is a real thing. That is a work and not a shoot. Or shoot, not a work for fucking Tay Allen.
Yeah, dude, I remember how legitimately terrified we were when we had her on for the first time. And you're like, oh, yeah, Tay Allen's, come on. Like, what are we going to say? And you're like, I don't know.
I mean, it was going to be fun either way, right?
Well, we knew it would be interesting either way. I don't know how much, you know, it could have been very not fun and awkward.
It might have been not fun for us.
Yes,
correct. It would have been fun for the audience no matter what.
That's
because, like, that's really all that matters. And also, it's like, you know we can both squirm. You know, we're good squirmers.
Yeah, a little bit.
So, do you want to do trial by jury?
Yeah, we can follow up on that. Man, we just burned a half an hour, man. That we plowed through. That's like we're half an episode in. All right, so we got a bunch of stuff that has been vetted. Normally, I would vet a bunch of these myself and then present them to you. Like, these are my favorites of the dead birds and the mouse.
Chat room, I'll tell you, can I get a big, fat, hairy shout out for Mech, M-E-K,
M-E-K,
and California Carl.
California
in the
Carl.
Chat. They not only do such a great job with the link talk, but Carl specifically has been stepping his game up when it comes to curating stuff. Like, he is just being an absolute baller with it. So huge shout out.
It's huge. Is it Carl that puts together the show doc every time? Because they always put amazing gifts to
and apparently DR_RB also, and because I did notice he was the one who shared it with us this week.
By the way, Night Attack Picks, you need to follow on Twitter because they send out a bunch of these photoshops that are just extraordinary.
We have the best people.
Yeah, you hear that? You hear that? Other competing shows live on the air right now.
Are we doing it?
Yeah.
No, Ashley and April are streaming. They do a live stream every Thursday, and whenever we're not on Thursday, everybody should watch them. But they stream games and stuff like that.
But when we're on,
when
you
we're
fucking
on,
turn that shit off.
Where's my camera? fucking crush it. I own this day.
Okay, keep going. Yeah.
Oh, you want to cut a promo?
Go for it.
Hey, ladies, you think you run Thursday? Huh? You think you're going to walk around using your Minecraft blocks, playing your Borderlands pre-sequels? Well, guess what? Daddy's home, and we're talking about Brian's leg-fucking adventures. This is what real content looks like. Not some Twitch bullshit. Oh, look, we're going to build a cubbyhole. Brian's cubbyhole is what he learned in a Houston library. It's where a penis goes when it is enveloped by a calf and a thigh, jerking it to completion. That's entertainment, folks.
For the record, Brian never engaged in leg fucking.
Really? You learned all about that and you never even tried once?
Well, it's...
Let's stop talking about this all. I just realized, like, I played out in my head, like, okay, where can this conversation go? None of them...
None of them good.
No, none of them could.
Well, maybe I should say, never engaged in leg fucking with her.
That's why I said stop. I asked you to stop and you didn't. I'm living off the largesse of your wife to fucking stay here, like, for, like, you know, 7 days over the next fucking month. All right. So trial by jury. An element of this show that I think has kind of been a little bit lost, because what we used to do on...
Everything was a contest.
On NSFW, everything was a contest, and we did a lot of viral stuff, a lot of viral video stuff. Now, if you like that, you can, if you subscribe on Patreon, you get first all of our pre-show and after shows. The pre-show is very often, you doing tech tweaking while watching the viral videos that are brought in.
Sure,
there's
actually a surprising, like, if you just want something on in the background, if you're a fan of, you know, those old school radio days where you could just have it feel like someone's in the room with you, it very much feels like that. If you're working on bullshit, just turn it on and leave it on. You'll get enough out of it.
But we used to open up every show with a viral video.
Yeah.
And then when we did Night Attack, in a way to kind of make it feel a little bit different, we decided to do
cold opens.
Cold opens very quickly, like within a week.
Became fucking magic.
Became magic because of spearmint nitrate. And so now we've stuck with those. That's what we do to open the shows. But periodically, we like to gather up the best and the brightest. Brian goes ahead and shows them to me. And I let you know what you need to be a fan of. As far as viral
videos.
Well,
it's basically, we bring you the best, like cats bringing you dead birds and hoping that you like them. You either say, oh, that's adorable, or you kick us and say, get the fuck out of here.
So we are here. A bunch of leg fuckers.
Yeah, that's all I want to say, too.
When I started cutting hair, I started with a simple philosophy. Great looks at great prices.
Was not good, and it had every right to be.
It was the gags were all the funny names for the haircuts that they did.
For anybody who's just listening to it, we had a bunch of like funny names and fucked up haircuts. Number one, the haircuts should have been more fucked up because the internet. By the way,
several of them awfully close to Brian's mullet adventure. Working on.
I didn't want to.
All y'all motherfuckers writing the 90s want their haircut back. Guess what? I'm going all the way back to 1991.
I didn't want to say it.
Yeah.
But I will.
Yeah.
The hair cut for you and your youngest daughter is identical.
What do you mean? Me and Callie?
You and Callie. Both
have the exact.
Now, by the way, she's an infant and doesn't have to, like, impress anybody.
Yeah.
You are the leader of a publicly facing internet empire.
Yeah.
And yet you both have just this, like, total mullet, like like hair hanging out the back, like situation going on.
We're shooting Scam School tomorrow, and I do not have time to get a haircut, so it's just gonna get increasingly.
Fuck it. It's gonna get weird. Here's the problem with this video: number one, the haircut should have been more fucked up, and number two, you should have had somebody saying the names.
Yeah,
like, cause that's funny. It's funny if it feels more.
You could sell like, it. It adds a second layer.
Cause also the joke is that these are funny, like because they're fucked up haircuts and they're silly names,
right?
And that somebody would make a commercial about them,
right?
So you need to go all the way toward that and be like, yeah, no, we also hired a voiceover guy to say like the Lucky Pierre.
Yeah,
like come on, man.
Yep.
So bullshit. Oh wait, all fuck. Right, oh, I had a whole thing.
What?
What? Do we have a plug-in for this? What? I had a board for this.
I don't know if this shit reaches. No, maybe look down on the ground. There might be an extension cord. It'll be quarter inch or eighth inch to eighth inch. And Brian's just going to keep singing as he realizes that he's got no play to do anything but sing a song. Talk about Justin's underwear peeking out as he grabs some wires from the corner. What's up? You think you guys can sing like Bruce Springsteen while one of your partners looks for wires? You can't do that bullshit. What, are you going to make some blocks? The only blocks you need are cocks.
Right.
God damn it. This is not the right. Sorry, I got distracted. None of these are right.
No.
Well, these are all male. This is too many cocks. We're looking for a female. Probably shouldn't have made fun of the fact that there's a competing podcast with wonderful females. Actually, that might work. Give that over here.
Give it here.
Yeah.
Hang on. Pierce.
Man. You want to go see if we can... I found out, allegedly, where Alex Jones's house is, and it's less than 2 miles away, by as the crow flies. Like, I could, I ride my bike past that area.
Who told you?
I forgot who said it. They were like... Or the context. They were... I think it might have been that dude at the liquor store, actually.
Oh man, he has information.
See if we got something.
All right.
Is that?
In? Oh no, it crashed. Hold on.
Okay.
Thank goodness.
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
All right. Here we go. Hey, Justin, what did you think of that video?
Boo! You suck.
This is a long way to go, but so worth the payoff. Let's hear the next video.
All right. This looks like some kind of kung fu fighting. Like they're practicing against one of those wooden dummies.
They're doing Tai Chi.
Is that Tai Chi? That looks like kung fu.
Well, it's just like slow as shit, so I assume it's Tai Chi.
Yeah. I think this may be all it is.
I'm gonna Brody this one. Fuck it.
Yeah, that's just this. This is all we got.
Yeah.
Do you have a Brody? You don't have Brody on there?
No, this is just a woo and boo board.
Oh, got it. All right, here we go. Oh, Jesus. I just looked at the lower right-hand corner.
Who are you?
I'm the cook.
Woo! Yes! I kind of wonder whether or not this is not like the new way that pornography sites can advertise.
Yeah, is by looking like bad porns.
Well, yeah, just, I mean, like, they know what they got. They got it in abundance. A bunch of people who are better at fucking than acting. They force them to act. They fucking record that. They put that out there. It's the least embarrassing thing that these people fucking do.
Wouldn't it be amazing if, like, the Brassers brand became better known for its
awesome...
its
comedy?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Your number one comedy. Also, we have a sex website.
I really didn't like it as soon as, like, it stopped being funny and started being hardcore DP.
So you know what this is a parody of, right?
This guy,
This is a straight parody.
From Under Siege, right?
Under Siege, yeah. He looks all ashamed of himself.
The kung fu is fucking amazing.
This guy's...
It's actually laughing. Better than those assholes before.
Yeah. The taking a bow moment for nobody there after he snaps the neck and murders the dude is amazing. Like, yes, that's right. I think a little bit of in the ring showmanship.
Who are you?
Oh, look. She has a little.
You got a little. Someone wants a napkin.
Some a little
yeah,
bit,
you got a little thing there.
Is she a vampire? Is that the character?
I'm the cook.
That's great. So again, if you didn't hear it,
woo! Yeah, definitely. Wow. So that's the current champion, right? I don't think this one's called.
If you have not watched this in a while, the way that we do things here are
Jesus Christ.
New champion woo, same champion boo style. So
it's Booper.
Right now.
Fuck.
For the audio listeners, Brian brought up the first frame of the next video, which is like just a fat ass, like right in the face. This is a fucking are you gonna take me home tonight fat bottom girl situation in this first frame of this next video.
Well, and if I'm not...
All right, real quick. Here's how it works, and we're gonna fucking talk about this ass coming up. If we like this video more, it becomes the champion. If you lose, then you lose to the new champion going forward. Everybody in the chat room at the final battle will be whatever the current champion is versus the favorite rejected former champion. So here we go. This is the fat ass video.
Yes, that works for me. Geez. Am I watching this? Am I playing this? That's about as much as I can.
No, come on.
I am definitely looking at the fringe of her anus.
It's a video called Fat Ass on a Bike.
Fast Ass.
Fast Ass.
That
oh.
ass is going very fast. Thank you, World Star Hip Hop.
I mean,
yeah.
Why are you ashamed?
Because, because it's like, I don't mind.
We just showed a clip from a hardcore pornographic film.
That's fine, though, because I wasn't getting a chubby watching that. You know, this shit is like, it's like...
It was more graphic to see a woman with semen on her face.
Oh,
than this.
Yeah, dude, this is a real mostly naked butt. It's the DJ.
It's a thong-clad butt. Ain't you never been to Brazil?
All right. Are you giving it a woo or a boo?
No.
Boo this man!
Not as good. Not as good as I'm the cook.
Oh, jeez. This definitely looks like it's probably a porn. From the silver
screen. These all porn, guys? We're just gonna do porn all night?
This is I'm counting down to titties in 3, 2, 1.
So but wait, this looks like a silent film.
God damn it! Fuckers,
and
God,
it is
God.
Indeed like a Steamboat Willie style animation. A black and white, a line drawn animation that the first frame was a dude's giant dick.
I would like to point out in the chat, somebody says, those related videos, though. If you look off on the right-hand side.
I can't read it. What
Kama
does it say?
Kama Sutra, choose your fantasy. Live sex scene in a show. Safer sex anime. Sexy cartoon. How to win at rock, paper, scissors every time. Scam school. Wow, man.
Yeah.
Man. Boo! You suck!
We wasted no time in the
world
of animation.
I'll turn that clip down. So.
Oh, yeah, that's fun.
All right, this is fat-ass pussycast girl with the biggest pussy lips. And it's a girl squeezing her pussy lips together. I mean, all right. Listen.
Boo, you suck.
Yeah, man.
This Come on. We used to have videos with songs. Nyan Cat. Fucking remember? Remember Nyan Cat?
Dude, those were good times.
Hold on. These were all vetted?
Yeah. Those were all green lit.
Fucking come on, guys. Remember when I shouted out California Carl? <Yeah. laughs>
Who vetted this dashboard? Oh,
shots fired.
Heute ist der Tag, jetzt geht es endlich los. Sie erreichen ihre Ziele.
Denken Sie groß.
Ein bisschen großen Wahnsinn kann nicht schaden. Und auf einmal können Sie fliegen.
Denken Sie groß. Gehen Sie
nicht raus. Video, I believe it's meant to look like a kid doing a tutorial video. Yeah. It's meant to look like a YouTube video of a kid doing a tutorial, but instead it's obviously talented artists putting together this crazy 3D adventure. Unless of course the kid actually did this, in which case I would be very surprised.
It's I don't know, like German rap or something. You know they rap in Germany now?
Man, they're finally catching up to us.
Yeah. I guess now the 3D thing explodes out
from blowing up.
Hey, Brian.
Yeah.
I got something to say.
What?
Boo, you suck.
Yeah.
So right now, our champion is still a clip from Brazzers.com.
We better hurry up. We're creeping up on an hour, man. We got 10 minutes. We got to plow through this.
I don't know if everybody understands the legacy here that we are trying to fill. But what we have shown thus far has been nothing short of embarrassing.
Okay. Tinky says, I submit one of my classmates' clips real quick. Tinky did our wonderful animation at the beginning. This is someone's Project Final anime. It's a dude and a chick, maybe zombies. They look a little
zombie. They're just kind of sunken.
Maybe gaunt.
Let's check it out, Dad Zombie Asno.
Deal with this.
Oh no, the girl got shot. Oh no, the guy did. Oh.
It can never be unmade.
I mean, like, good, but... And thankfully it wasn't hardcore pornography.
We'd rather see corpses getting shot in the skull.
Yeah, I mean, all due respect.
Move this man!
All right, Hot Dog Factory, do you trust it? How it's made, hot dogs. Oh, this is literally just footage from How It's Made.
Wait, hold on, wait a minute. Let it go.
Swear to Christ, if you give this a pass over that other shit...
Let's see if it goes somewhere.
God damn it, Justin. It's like it makes no... It's like, how is that remotely what a hot dog factory would sound like?
Hey, Brian.
What?
Woo!
God damn it!
Yeah!
New champion!
No, they don't call it trial by bubba. They call it trial by jury.
So anybody who's just listening to it, it was just footage of a hot dog factory from How It's Made with people doing and jerk off sound effects with their mouth.
Yep.
Over top of it. It was brilliant.
Get dogs pumped.
Konnichiwa. Watashi wa Real Ultimate Power Kenkyushou no Kakakusha desu. Konkai anata no aiken no tame dake ni taisetsu na message ga arimasu. 愛犬家の人はぜひ画面の前に犬を座らせてください。そして部屋を出てドアを閉めてください。私は科学者です。どうも。
Those dog bones.
Ginger! Sasha! Duke! Coco! Buster! I'm talking to all the dogs of planet Earth! It's time to get the dogs pumped!
God, that was amazing.
Brian?
Yes, sir.
Woo! 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 Woo!
You're saying just call woo, it in. This is it. Woo, woo. Hey, you're saying gonna beat that.
Listen, remember 5 minutes ago when I was giving you guys all sorts of shit? Just when I thought you couldn't get any fucking dumber, you go and do this, and totally redeem yourself. Oh, my hot doggin', good God Christ. It was fucking amazing. That's a viral. I mean, that's a video that I would not be shocked has 2 million by the end of the year, man.
Says here that it was posted on May 30th, 2014. And guess how many views it has?
I saw 30-something, right?
30,000. 36,000.
Fucking, everybody needs to spread the word. Dude, you need to get these dogs pumped right now.
I'm going to tweet out right now. You need to get your dogs pumped. I'm going to write
stick. I just like it when it gets very specific on how they're going to destroy the world. That's the best.
It has that perfect pacing where it just gets enough larger each time, and then just when you're getting tired of it, then they go, destroy planet Earth!
Yeah, I mean, just when you think it's going to be just avant-garde, it gets literal, which is the best part. By the way, did I ever tell you my Kickstarter idea to be the most reviled person in America?
Well, are you the guy who loves Hitler?
No, although that's a great plan for being hated. So here's my idea.
It's called Real Ultimate Power for Dogs was the title they did.
You write a song, and it's very catchy.
Yeah.
Kind of like kids bop level song, right?
Yeah.
It's called The Screaming Song.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, okay. All right.
So that's funny.
And it's
right?
All like, hey, little kids, let's scream. Ah! Yeah. Hey, little kids, let's scream. Ah!
Exactly. So it's something that's catchy, fun, right? And it's just like, when your teacher talks, scream. When your parents talk, scream.
When you don't get your way, scream.
Let's scream right now. Scream. Ah! Yeah. Something like great. So annoying, right? No. That's only half the plan.
Oh, okay.
That just makes you an annoying person.
Yeah.
Doesn't make you the most reviled person in America.
I do a Kickstarter. And I say, I'm going to buy as many commercials on Nickelodeon and Disney as I can. I'll get the rate sheets. And I'll say, hey, listen, whoever just wants to destroy all the households with kids in America, just donate in here.
All right, well, see, here's the trick, right?
Yeah.
Because you'll get a lot of people who think it'd be funny to, you know, fuck with all the parents and the kids. But I think there's more money in the parents. So what you do is you start with that, and then you start another Kickstarter, but like you've shaved.
I will cancel.
Yes, I will stop all of these screaming videos if we hit my goal of $1 million.
Oh my God, that's great. You found the second half. Because you say, hey, listen, I'm going to raise as much money as it takes to buy as many commercials as possible, right?
Yeah.
And then another video that's like, hey, listen, I'm the guy who's going to destroy your life.
Right.
This might be something small B blackmail, but let's just get to the fucking point, right? I will pocket all the money that these other people have given me, ruining my reputation with them for your benefit if you also pay me more than what they've paid me.
And you could have like a live pay-per-view countdown as we're like, ah!
It's like either I get my blood money, I get money of both the Kickstarters, or I give the one Kickstarter's money to Disney and Nickelodeon.
Here we go. Let's take a look at it. You got a few more left in you?
Yeah, let's go. I don't know if anyone's going
to
beat
numerals
that.
Two numbers will give you a clue that will lead you to a person's name. You take that person's initials, it translates into Roman numerals, then you translate that into regular numbers. Ken?
What is 550?
That's it, David Letterman. Ken?
What is 400?
C.D., Charles Darwin. Yeah. Ken?
What's 1500?
Yeah.
Roman numeral 1600.
Ken?
What is 150?
Yes, for Charles Lindbergh.
And
Ken?
What is 200?
200. Chris Carter, C.C.
Oh, man, wasn't it? I was expecting a left turn, and we didn't get one. It kind of just exactly delivered on what you expected.
Well, and you have to kind of, because it's kind of confusing that he's actually solving the thing and not like that. It's not like some weird.
I thought it was
going to
be a commentary on how fucked up a convoluted category it was.
Yeah.
Where it's like, yeah.
Also, normally the Thug Life stuff, you have to like, it's like a look in the camera. That somebody's being kind of badass.
Yeah.
Or they think they're being,
I mean,
like,
he sort
white
of dropped
guy badass.
The mic at the end, but yeah. Man.
Oh.
Oh.
It can never be unmade.
This is a sandstorm.
My diarrhea.
That's amazing.
Song name is for every single thing, and the answer is always Sandstorm by Darude. Darude Sandstorm is, I believe, the technical.
Brian, that was fucking great.
Yeah.
Boo! You suck.
It just wasn't as good as pumping
Not
dogs.
Not as good as fucking pumping up the dogs, bro.
Yeah. No.
I want somebody who is in this list, who knows these videos, to give us the best. No one of these random fucking green links, man. Like,
You guys tell us. Yeah, we're down to the wire,
we're down
man.
To the
we're
fucking...
out of time. Let's see it in the chat. You guys give us your one. Stake your reputation on the next one you do.
I'm saying I ain't gonna claim to be Hame, but we are down to the wire here.
Yeah. In the meantime, interrogation video. Now the problem is this is normally not a good thing. It says interrogation video must watch through 30 seconds.
Hey. Although the dog one was long.
There was enough to get me there.
Oh,
right,
I've also
at the
seen
game.
This.
Have you?
If you have not seen it,
I'm going to ask you again to take it out of the bag and put it in the machine.
Oh, this is from True Detective, right?
It is.
This isn't just a clip, is it?
No.
Okay. All right, I say that's go time. That means it has got to be go time. Four. All right.
Don't look at me.
British man. Creepy British man. Creepy British man. Can we have an interview?
If you want to meet Piers, you best fuck Diz.
Well, I'm the only person who thought that was funny. mainly because I don't know if what you're saying is D-E-A-R-S or D-E-E-R-S.
Like, are you showing me this?
Lovely ladies.
A creepy British man doesn't mean I have a lot of life.
Oh God, that's great. That was fantastic.
Apparently, by the way, that was something that they were that the creator of that video was trying to get to our attention, like in the height of like True Detective fever.
And we missed it. Oh, dude, look, it's
and didn't yeah no he I'm like threw sorry. It up in the Reddit and was like, last chance for this fucking video.
That we are terrible people. Let's shout out. Looks like Shodan Kid put that together, and he probably hates us now. He's like, fuck that show.
Yeah, I don't know. I've been actually enjoying We Have Concerns lately. So, like, you know,
dude,
it's actually a better show. You know?
That is amazing. all right, we got one more real quick. What do we got here?
Night Attack sucks cock.
Night Attack, Hitler.
What?
Abort Leo Laporte. Night Attack sucks cock.
Night Attack.
What the fuck is happening?
Yeah, man.
Keep playing it.
Well, it's the same thing.
I know.
Abort Leo Laporte.
This is like a whole new like genre of video, right?
No. This is a thing where you blur out like, faces and show vomiting kids.
Basically, no. It's like this like super oranges. Glitchy.
Oh, got it.
Like all sorts of random
artifacted
gifts. Like,
yeah.
It's like
kinda
this
like
whole
YouTube
new.
Boop or...
Well, yeah. I forget. Like, I know there's a name for it. It's like, it's some like sarcastic kind of like, you know, perfected name or something. Where it's like, it's just a lot of random text and shit like that. But like, it's pretty rad. I like that. Although, like, the only thing that I'm curious about is like, and I guess the point is that there is no point, but it's like, which side is he on? He's on the side that thinks that, man, Leo Laporte should be aborted and Night Attack sucks.
Maybe he's pressing the abort
button. I like to call him the majority of humanity.
Treadmill fail into push-up recovery. You want to throw this at, then we're done?
I feel like, I mean, come on, guys. Like, this is the last. I didn't see it.
Okay, good. All right, there we go. Treadmill fail into push-up recovery, and it goes like this.
I just gotta feel that was set up.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, you're right. Oh, they even had a hot girl walking by. This is a skit.
Ooh, you suck!
That's the guy just shouting at his push-ups.
Yeah.
Man, I guess that's it. It's gotta
I bet
be...
you that got a lot of likes on Lad Bible.
On what?
Lad Bible.
What is Lad Bible?
I don't know. I think it's a thing.
Is
Otherwise,
it?
It's my... joke about everything on Facebook that's like, this dude ate a full steak. Check it out on Lad Bible.
Tell me Lad Bible's a real thing. Here's Bikey Wars. Yeah, I don't know.
I'm a bikey man from a bikey gang, living in my crack den making crack. I love killing, thieving, and extortion. Give me 20 bucks, I'll give you an abortion. I love cocaine and selling it to kids. I charge 50 for an ounce, and my dad used to fuck me rippity D.
My name's Snake, I'm from a rival gang, so give me the drugs or I'll go bang. I'm a real rough bloke, I'll murder your wife, so give me the drugs or you'll be in strife.
Oh no! He's got the drop on me, but lucky I got a trick up my sleeve. Bang! Biggity bang! A big bang bang, biggity, biggity bang! And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing bam boom, and he's effing dead!
Stop right there, I'm a crooked cop. Give me a bribe or all your drugs will stop.
If you...
Oh, you gangsters are such big roughies. I'm gonna put you in handcuffies.
Oh, no! It's the boys in blue. What the hell am I gonna do? Bang! Biggity-bang! Biggity-bang, bang, biggity-biggity-bang! And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing, bam, boom, and he's effing dead.
Well, hello there. I'm just a passerby, and I...
Bang! Biggity-bang! Biggity-bang, bang, biggity-bang! And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing, bam, boom, and he's effing dead.
I'm not gonna lie, that's a great hook.
Bang, bang, biggity bang.
Brian.
Yes, sir.
We saw a lot of really good videos.
Yeah, we did.
Scratch that. We saw two really good videos.
Yeah.
And I have to say that of all of the videos, this fucking Red Lobster ad will not.
Yeah, should I just search for it over here?
Damn it. I was gonna fucking. Like, I was trying to set some shit up.
Yeah. No,
Red Lobster fucking ruins everything. No. I swear to God, if anybody goes to a fucking... Give me the camera. I'm cutting a promo on Red Lobster. Hey, fuck dicks. You like cheddar biscuits? Well, then how about you take your cheddar biscuits and shove them up your urethra? Fucking Red Lobster is the worst place to go in the world. Their fish is made of AIDS. And if you try to fucking get a lobster, you're going to crack through the hard shell of failure that envelops your entire life. Fuck you, Red Lobster, and your pre-roll ads. I'm trying to set up a fucking bit here.
Oh, wait, so you didn't actually want to play a Red Lobster ad? I thought this was a particularly funny Red Lobster ad that you were trying to get to.
No, I'm trying to fucking, like, set up that, like, you know, there's going to be a winner, and I'm going to... announce who it is, but I didn't want to have a fucking Red Lobster ad play before it, and then the Red Lobster ad fucking
it's going great. Look, nobody's noticed. Be cool, man. Just keep it together. Keep it together. Let's hear it.
Brian, we saw a lot of good videos.
We saw two good videos.
Scratch
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
We saw two good videos. I'm doing the whole thing over again.
Oh, got it. So dial it back. Clean.
I have to say.
Yeah.
What was it called? Biggity Bang?
Bikey Wars.
Bikey Wars.
Bikey Wars by... Auntie Donna, A-U-N-T-Y.
And that's under a million, right?
No, dude, 800,000, man.
And when did it go up?
September 3rd, 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen.
It's simmering gold.
Bikey Wars.
Woo!
Is our champion!
Everything's going wrong. It's all ruined.
At least we were able to see it.
It's all gone.
We need to show Tay Allen's ass again. Maybe it'll shut down the stream.
Play with that bum, 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 bum. This was us trying to bust out. There you go.
Here we go.
There we go. Right on, man. Hey, look at that. We did a bonus episode. We even went longer than an hour. Thanks to everybody who tuned in live. Thanks to everybody who participated over live. We're live at nightattack.tv, at brickslap.tv, at diamondclub.tv. Wouldn't it be great if all those were just the same place, Justin?
I think Night Attack will always need to be Night Attack, right? Because it's a great place to find the
episodes. It's a great brand.
It's a great brand.
For being hated.
But there's been discussions about the slaps.
Oh, there's a lot of talks. There's words. Look, man, here, let's go ahead. I feel like we got to go out on a different song than usual. Somebody throw me a link to the
bang, 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 biggity bang.
You know what? Actually, though, let's go out to this. Here we go.
He's gonna drop on me.
We're now big fans of Auntie Donna.
Bang!
biggity-bang. A biggity-bang, bang, biggity, biggity-bang. And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing, bam, boom, and he's effing dead.
Stop right there, I'm a crooked cop. Give me a bribe or your drugs will stop.
F you.
Oh, you gangsters are such big roughies. I'm gonna put you in handcuffies.
Oh no, it's the boys in blue. What the hell am I gonna do? Bang! Biggity-bang, a biggity-bang, bang, biggity, biggity-bang. And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing, bam, boom, and he's effing dead.
Well, hello there, I'm just a passerby, and I just...
Bang! Biggity-bang, a biggity-bang, bang, biggity, biggity-bang. And a shoot, 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 put a bullet in your head. Bing, bam, boom, and he's effing dead.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.